feel like it's really important to, you know, show people like what it really is. And step closer, we ain't gonna let the devil win. We gonna get to it. What it do, legend crew? Welcome back to your girl's channel. It's about to be a major life update because your girl has so many things to share with you guys. Like, so much has been going on, like so much new stuff has been going on in my life. Like, honestly, just come with me, we gotta talk. You know, I haven't really been like on YouTube like that. I'm 25, you guys, and there's just so much that like has been happening in my life. I think like I'm really just struggling with finding out what I want to do in life. You know, like life is all about pivoting and like learning and growing and just going through experiences. Like, I've just never been the type of person, especially growing up in an Indian household, I was just never a person that you could really put inside of a box. And I think now I'm just kind of like realizing that I'm so grateful for everything that I've been through in life, but now I'm just kind of coming to that age where I'm like, okay, like I really need to figure out what it is that I want to do. Now I'm about to move out. I've been living by myself for like 4 years, but this year when I moved into this apartment, I did live with my boyfriend, but now I'm changing a lot in my life. Like, my life is just completely transitioning. I'm about to be just focusing on me and myself and having my own space and just really focusing on my career and gaining stability in every aspect of my life. Relationships, friendships, financially, career-wise, everything. This vlog is gonna be just me basically maneuvering through it all because I'm so stressed out. I have no idea where I'm gonna go yet. I have no idea what I'm gonna do yet. I just have been planning a lot, and like I said, a lot's been happening, y'all. I lost my car and I'm so sad, but I'm about to get a better car, so I don't even care. I feel like when I move alone and when I move into my own apartment in my own space, I feel like it's gonna be a lot better because I just feel like living with somebody this young was just kind of like, I mean, it was amazing while it lasted. I cherished every moment that we had, good and bad, but I think I'm just ready to go back into my own space, into my own element, into my own era, and I'm just so excited for this journey. I'm gonna get emotional talking about it, but y'all are gonna come with me on this journey of just moving and figuring life out, and I'm gonna do a little home tour video before I leave, so yeah, but I'll be right back. I have to go run some errands, and I will be back with y'all. We are currently on day one of trying to move and figure out what the hell I'm gonna be doing. Like, I feel like I know it's real when I'm sitting down on my bed talking to y'all like this. This has been the most transitional time for me. And I'm really, really emotional because this was way more than just like a place to live. This truly became like my dream home, my dream apartment. And you know, I feel like when people see what you have and people see you get to a certain place in your life, people don't really understand what it took for you to get to where you are. People don't really see the struggles that you face. People don't really see the things that you have to go through in order to get to the good and get to the joy and get to the success. People only see the success and just automatically think that your life is perfect or life is all good. It took me a long, long way just to get to where I am today and to be able to give myself the things that I wanted, and you know, a lot of sacrifice I had to do in order to make that happen. So you know, now I'm just trying to learn how to shut doors and kind of just open new ones for myself. I honestly don't know where I'm gonna be moving to. I'm gonna kind of a weird situation right now, which I don't want to get too into, but I've been really, really going through it, y'all, and really just struggling trying to figure out my next move. It's been, I really love to document stuff because like it's important to see your growth. It's important to be real with what you're going through and be real with people, and I just don't believe in faking stuff or acting like I just have it all together, because right now I'm in a very sticky situation and I'm just trying to figure it out day by day. It is okay to be in a place where
you just don't know how things are gonna go. It is okay to be in a place where you feel like everything is falling apart. It is okay to feel like you're unworthy or you're unloved, and like, you know, like you just are literally feeling idle. If you're feeling idle and if you're feeling so stuck and if you're feeling like you're questioning why things are happening, I just want to tell y'all that y'all are not alone. And you know, the couple months, you know, before filming this, I've been really going through it. And I'm not the type to, like, you know, record me, like, talking about what I go through. I'm not the type to record and document the intimate moments of my life. But I feel like last year and this year have really changed my perspective on a lot of things. And I just feel like it's really important to, you know, show people like what it really is, and just be real. People only want to show the good. People only want to talk about the good and kind of just make it seem like they got everything together. But I don't know if y'all know, but I did move in with my best friend, who became my boyfriend. But now we decided to just kind of like focus on ourselves, which I think is so important. I know I'm gonna get through it. I think it's just a lot of change happening at once. And I'm just in a state where I feel really, really alone right now. Yeah, and that's just where I'm at right now, you guys. But I just want to say thank y'all for supporting me and tuning into this video. Like, I'm going to vlog everything. I'm going to, you know, document everything. And we're going to see how this moving goes, because it can only get better from here. You know, I told myself that this year one of my biggest resolutions was to be more simple and, you know, more minimalistic, and just try to cherish the good things, of not focus on anything negative or anything bad. If something doesn't work out, let it go. I think God puts us through a lot of things and struggles and battles to make us stronger. I truly believe everything happens for a reason. And now I'm just at the state where I'm just giving it all to God, and I'm just really trying to like wake up every day positive. I'm trying to wake up every day getting through what I gotta get through, and just not staying stagnant or idle in a feeling that I'm in, you know, and just pushing myself to just keep going and figure it out from there. So anyways, y'all, if y'all know anything about moving can be very stressful in your 20s, especially when, you know, you're still in the process of figuring things out. But I think I'm just really emotional, because like I really came here and started a lot of my home from scratch, and like didn't have a couch for like a year straight, and finally got me a couch. And like I just really worked hard for everything that I had, and I just never want anybody to, you know, look at what I have or what I had or what I'm about to get, and I never want y'all to think that this shit just comes from the fucking sky. Like, everything that you do in life, you have to work for it. Let me update y'all. So currently I have these boxes that I just got from U-Haul. I got about like 10 to 15, and I just kind of want to put everything to the side so that whenever the movers come, it could be easy. I want to record a few more episodes on my beautiful podcast wall before I leave and take some content right there, because I really like that area. And then as far as my kitchen, I feel like this is going to be the hardest thing to move. And then, of course, my room. I haven't even moved anything in my room yet. But, y'all, this is part of the process. Like, you know, when you're literally moving everything alone, and especially when you're not really, when you don't have, like, that much support, it can be very overwhelming doing all of this alone. You know what I mean? It's about to be, well, it's 4:23 p.m. right now. And I'm not gonna lie to y'all, I literally woke up today and toured apartments all morning with my mom. Thank God I have my mom in my life, because she has been so supportive and like just there for me and giving me her honest opinion and advice. And y'all, my mom is getting older, so that's another thing that I've been super emotional about, is just like seeing my mom get older. And I really just want to look after her and focus on taking care of her. And spending time with her before anything. This is just a reminder to like cherish the people in your life that actually care about you and that actually show you that they care about you. Because a lot of people will sit up here and say they care about you and they ride in with you and they mess with you and then be nowhere, like literally be nowhere to be found whenever things are going down in your life. And that's what matters the most, is
who's there for you when you're down, you know?
Gloomy day, as y'all could tell, it is so gloomy. Like, I'm about to meditate and pray and just eat good and relax because I am so tired, y'all. Thank y'all for supporting me during this process because it is a process, y'all. Okay, y'all. So here is an update. Currently packing up my entire crib. I'm almost done with everything. To give y'all an update, my best to make this vlog as like real as possible because I feel like a lot of times, like especially throughout my YouTube, like I'm pretty much only showing like the good and the successful moments. Just don't care. Like I just don't want to portray that like my life is perfect. I don't want to portray just the good things. Like having mental breakdowns and feeling stagnated and feeling like you're in a hole and feeling like you're just all over the place. Like this is real life, y'all. Like I literally woke up today, took a shower, and I've been just staying at my house. I called in to work because I just didn't have the mental space to go to work today. Like I feel like this month has been really hard for me, you know? I'm going through it. Like trying to just be strong every day. I'm trying to focus on the positive. I'm just trying to like move forward with life without feeling the weight of everything on my shoulders, because I know a lot of times, like, you know, we just wake up, we put our game face on, and we just keep going. We keep going with life because that's all you can do at the end of the day. Nobody's gonna pick you up but yourself, you guys. Like, take this from somebody like me. Like, you will never find peace. You will never find happiness. You will never find joy if you don't choose that for yourself. And a lot of times, that comes with really hard choices in life. That's just what I wanna say. This is my update, you guys. I'm so, so happy that I'm packing up. It honestly feels really refreshing. But I'm also gonna miss this place so much. Like, this home is like everything to me, you guys. Like I have literally created so much clarity in this space. I've cried, I've healed, I've laughed. I have all the memories that I've had here with people and family, and now I'm really letting go of a lot. So change is always hard, but growth is uncomfortable, and that's okay. This is a reminder that if you are in an uncomfortable situation, it's okay. Because you have to be uncomfortable, you have to go through pain, you have to go through sorrow, but there's an equivalent amount of joy that is coming to match the sorrow that you go through. And I really just want to instill that in y'all's heart. If y'all are watching this, it does get better. This is a long journey, y'all. It's currently 2 weeks before my lease is ending. I'm honestly about to go to the pool and relax. I've had the longest day ever. I've just been so drained, so I'm about to get me water, my journal, a book, go out there, read, pray, and just relax, because a girl has been going through it. Y'all, tell me why I FaceTimed friends this week. They all answered the phone and was like, "Are you okay?" And I'm like, "Do I look that bad? Like, do I look that crusty? Do I look that rough?" I have packed up my skincare, my body care, my hair care, and I didn't even think about like the next 2 weeks. So I'm really just, this is me, y'all. This is me, and it's either y'all with me or you not. And that's just all I gotta say. I have a friend with me. I am dog sitting for the weekend. That's literally typical me, dog sitting while I can't even sit myself, but it's all good. His name is Milo. He is like the best dog in the entire world. Honestly, he's so obedient. Watch. Milo, sit. Sit, baby. Good boy. Shake. Good boy. Down. Good boy. Roll over. Dogs really make everything better. Like, when you just see how simple they live. This is a camera. He's sniffing it. It's just a camera. But they're just so simple, and they, like, appreciate the smallest things. And y'all, it's literally storming like crazy. But my room is so empty right now, y'all. I'm just trying to enjoy my last 2 weeks here and like cherish everything and
really enjoy my time with, you know, my best friend. No matter what we're going through or no matter what terms we're on, like, I'm just trying to really be present and enjoy this, the next couple of weeks. I just want to close my eyes and this time is just done. But yeah, y'all, update. I love y'all. Peace. So a girl's just been going through it, y'all. Just something, like, the devil is really trying his best to, like, prolong this whole situation, and it's like, it's really pissing me off. But, you know, one step at a time, y'all, keeping y'all updated, and, you know, we one step closer, y'all. Dang. No such thing as a life that's better than yours. No such thing as a life that's better than yours. Love yours. No such thing as a life that's better than yours. No such thing, no such thing. Heart beating fast, let a nigga know that he alive. Fake niggas mad, snakes in the grass, let a nigga know that he arrived. Don't be sleeping on your level, cause it's beauty in the struggle, nigga. Beauty, beauty goes for all y'all. It's beauty in the struggle, nigga. Beauty, beauty. Let me explain. Yeah. It's beauty in the struggle, ugliness in the success. Hear my words and listen to my signal of distress. I grew up in the city and know sometimes we had less. Compared to some of my niggas down the block, man, we were blessed. And life can't be no fairy tale, no once upon a time. But I be goddamn if a nigga don't be trying. So tell me, mama, please, why you be drinking all the time? Does all the pain he brought you still linger in your mind? Okay, y'all. Huge. Huge update on my channel, you guys. I have not vlogged in so long. I think the last time I vlogged was when I was going through my moving, and it's been some time since then. Your girl is all dolled up, ready to go to a release party, and I still haven't found a place yet, y'all. My moving situation is still a little crazy, so I am staying with a friend of mine who is amazing. And, you know, we're taking things day by day. So, outfit of the day. About to change. Cheers. Your girl is getting ready to go to the Janae Aiko concert, period. Get full body. My hair is done natural, and I just kind of like put these, I don't know, rubber bands in my hair. So the last update that I have is moving out of my apartment, which, y'all, I loved that apartment so much, and I wasn't necessarily attached to it, but I do feel like I worked really hard to obtain that apartment, and I was living with, you know, my significant other at the time. However, now in my life right now, I am just moving forward, and I'm focusing fully on myself and my growth with God, and really just pouring back into myself, loving myself, enjoying life, enjoying my friends, enjoying people, making memories without, you know, questioning anything. And I'm 25, you guys, and I feel like
my 20s so far have been such a journey, and it's been amazing. Like, every single year of my 20s has been amazing and memorable. But now I'm 25 and I feel like my life just kind of like went, so not even downhill because God is so good, but literally life just hit me at once as soon as I turned like 24 25, and now I'm entering the most pivotal years of my life, which is my years until 30. So I just, you know, I felt like I was wasting a lot of time around certain people, being around the wrong people, being around people that just weren't leading me to my divine purpose. So this is me right now, and I'm just being super honest with y'all, and what I choose to share with y'all. Know that no matter what you do in life, make sure that you're happy, make sure that you're taken care of no matter what before anybody else. But yeah, right now I'm just staying with friends. I've stayed with two friends so far, and what I've learned in life is that when you really, really go through a hard time, you have to really pay attention to the people that are there for you. And what I notice is that a lot of people that I've been there for, and that I've supported, and that I've helped with anything and everything, were not to be found whenever I truly needed help. And I just really am in an era where I'm learning, like, all the real people in my life, all the people that love me and that care about me. And, like, I've just never felt this much love and support in my circle before. And honestly, this had to happen. The season of just being stuck or not being able to move or move forward with my situation or my living condition or whatever the case may be, I feel like God has bless me with so many people that are able to just help me and love me, and I could not be more happier. So right now I literally moved everything to a storage, you guys. So right now I'm focusing on just the right path, building a strong foundation for myself, surrounding myself with good people, loving people, caring people, and just people that match my energy, because I am somebody that I give so much and I pour into others so much. And a lot of times people who are like that, people will take their energy like crazy and they literally let life suck the living joy out of them. So I definitely hit rock bottom, but I am back and better. And you know, I'm so blessed, you guys. I literally cannot complain about anything. I'm so blessed. And yeah, I'm going to the Janae Aiko concert today. I'm so happy and excited about that. If you guys are here in this video, thank y'all so much for supporting me. Like, I will always say that every video. Like, thank y'all so much for tuning in and supporting me and making it this far in my career, in my YouTube journey. I know I haven't been the most consistent, but we're getting there and we're figuring it out. And I'm so excited to finally just get back on track and just to have my own place again, because God knows that I'm so ready. But we will take it day by day, and y'all are gonna join me on my journey. But I love you guys so much, and stay tuned for the rest of the video and the vlog. Zen out right now, as y'all can tell. Today's been a very emotional day for me, because I feel like I finally got to a place, ever since like my moving and like all the different types of change and like my breakup and just all types of stuff, family stuff, I feel like I finally am able to like breathe. Honestly, this is pretty much where we're at right now as far as the moving process. I finally am in my own space, in my own home, and it's just super bright Like, there's just so much light coming in, and it's, I literally just feel so, like, zenned out, and I feel at peace, and I can finally breathe, because for the longest, you guys, and this is just me being real, I was literally house hopping, staying with people, staying with my friends, getting Airbnbs, getting hotels, because it was just a struggle for me in my situation. Like, it was really hard, but you know, not getting too deep into it, but I do feel like I'm in a good place right now where I can finally get back comfortable being myself. If you guys haven't read the book of Job in the Bible, I strongly recommend reading that, because the book of Job is about a man that literally had so much faith and got tested countless times in a row, back to back, and God took everything from him. Like, when I tell you, everything from him, and he still remained faithful, and he multiplied everything times two for Job. So, long story short, I feel like when you're going through periods of like transition or like change, or just like not knowing like what the next step is, or not knowing where things are gonna go, or being scared to lose somebody, or giving up things that you love or people that you love, just know that God will never take anything from you if he doesn't have a better plan for you. And I think trust is such a beautiful thing, and that's what it's all about for me at the end of the day. Like, everything that happened for a reason, and honestly, I've just learned a lot of self-love during this time. So I'm gonna give y'all a little room tour, because I want y'all to see what my new vibe is right now. I think change of environment is super important, y'all. Like, getting into this environment, it's new, it's calm. Like, I simplified a lot of things. I got a storage and left a lot of things there, but simplicity, y'all, is like key to contentment. Like, I can tell y'all that right now. And overall, I'm just really happy, and I'm just in such a better headspace. Good morning. Okay, so major update. This is gonna be the day where I go and finally get me a car. I literally lost my car in the middle of like all the things that was going on in my life, like settling in, like having to like go from Airbnbs to hotels, and like not have no type of like stability, home wise, car wise. Like, I was just all over the place. And I'm really telling y'all this because I want y'all to know that if y'all are ever down bad, and if y'all are ever in a situation where like you are just struggling and you're down bad, please do not be afraid to reach out for help. This is the car that has gotten me through life, literally through life. My friend let me borrow this car when I was going through it, and she's let me borrow this car without even paying a dime, y'all, for like the longest. And shout out, okay, that's your name, if you're watching this, I freaking love you. I love you. You have literally saved me. You don't understand. Life is always like non-linear. It's a roller coaster. Everything is up and down. There's gonna be times where you crawl, there's gonna be times where you walk, there's gonna be times where you jump, run, all of that. And you have to go through the crawling stage in life, y'all, in order to really like know that like you can do whatever you want and desire. If you just work hard, if you just push through, if you just don't give up, if you just don't dwell in your problems, like just always push through everything, and slowly but surely everything will come together. And if you guys have ever gone through this situation, or have ever been in this situation, if y'all ever been living out your car, if y'all ever struggled with having like, you know, financial stability, you're not alone, okay? We're all freaking human. We all go through it. Biggest lessons was don't ever be afraid to ask for help, because you will really see who the real people are in your life when you are going through hell, okay? So that's all I wanted to say. I'm super excited, and yeah, y'all are gonna join me. Yo, guys,
stop playing with me. I'm so happy. And it just feels so good. You guys, this is like my first car that I actually like bought on my own. I said that my first goal this year was to be super minimal and simple and not go after too much like materialistic luxury stuff. Save my pocket, save my bread, and like actually start helping people more, like helping the homeless more, like doing more for like organizations, doing more for charity, and like pocketing the bread that I could be, that I use on like materialistic things and like luxury things, and I can literally just use that to make more of an impact in the world. And I just was like, let me go for something simple. And so I picked out this beautiful Mazda, and I'm so happy, you guys. Like, it literally is perfect. It's like, I'll put pictures right here. And yes, I am about to get Chick-fil-A because I am fat and I'm hungry. And I've been at the dealership all day. So happy. And thank you guys for joining me on this journey. I am just so thankful. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, God, for everything. And better times are coming. If y'all are going through the same thing I'm going through, one step at a time. Don't ever forget, one step at a motherfucking time. Okay,
y'all, so this is my new car.